Welcome to a new series on this channel. In this series, we will take a look at how we create a RESTful API with ReactPHP. Before we start, let's have a look at what exactly a RESTful API is, how it works, and what we should keep in mind while building it. So, what exactly a RESTful API is? Well, REST stands for Representational State Transfer. And the whole idea behind RESTful API really is that we can use it, this API, to transfer data around. That sounds too abstract, right? The main purpose why we want to use it is an alternative to a traditional web page, when this traditional web page doesn't fit our needs. So what is a RESTful API? Let's say that we have a client, which is our browser, for example. We are the client and we have some server, obviously like a web page. Then we send a request to some URL, we receive a response. And for an ordinary web page, for different URLs, we receive different web pages with some HTML. For example, we have a main page, a catalog, a product page, and so on. This is how traditional web pages work. But what about some other cases when we also want to request a server? But in response we don't really need HTML. Let's have a look. We still have a server, but now with different clients. Let's say we have a mobile application. And that mobile application obviously needs to store and fetch some data from the server. But the problem is that it doesn't need HTML for it. Instead, it uses some other data formats. One more example may be a single page application. Here we actually have a web page. But we need HTML only for the first request. For all other requests, we only want to exchange data, send something to the server and receive some data from it. So, the main difference with traditional web page is that in all these cases we don't care about HTML. We just want to send data back and forth. And very important to notice, RESTful API server is stateless. It doesn't care about individual clients that are connected to it. So, we have a client and we have a RESTful server with these endpoints. These are URLs supported by our server. Then each of these URLs might also support different actions defined by HTTP verbs. We have GET and POST requests for clients. For products we may also have a DELETE request. And for orders we may have GET, POST and PUT. This is how a RESTful API could look like. We have a couple of URLs and each URL then possibly may support a couple of different HTTP verbs. And then from our client we can send a request. In case of a web application it may be an AJAX request. Then we receive a response with some data, which if we are talking about a single page web application, we use to re-render the page. This is the idea behind the RESTful API. We have a server with URLs, each supports different types of HTTP requests. But all we are doing is exchanging the data. The format of data may be different, JSON, XML or something else. The important thing here is that these API endpoints are not supposed to be called directly by a user typing them in the browser. All these URLs are going to be requested by background calls, by JavaScript or a mobile app. So this is how we use RESTful API. We use it to exchange data. Because it is the only way we can connect our clients to the server, to some backend. These clients don't want HTML, they need data. And once again about the state, it is very important. RESTful API is stateless and client state is not persisted between requests. There is no session stored on the server. The server doesn't care about the client connecting to it. Okay, enough of theory, let's build a RESTful API.